Hey there, and welcome to the Grapless course on Android mobile app development with AI. I'm thrilled to have you here. To kick things off, our very first lesson is all about getting your development engine running by installing Android Studio. First things first, you need to grab the software. Just search for Android Studio or head straight to their official website. Make sure you download the latest version for your computer. During the download process, you'll need to review and accept the terms and conditions. Easy enough. Joining the Google Developer Program offers several benefits, particularly relevant for developers using tools like Android Studio. Once the download is complete, just open the file you downloaded to fire up the installer. The installation process is pretty straightforward. You'll just click install and then next as the guide prompts you. I'm going to fast forward through the actual installation so this video doesn't get too long. When it's finished, if you want to launch the software right away, make sure that little box that says Start Android Studio is checked, it usually is by default, and then click Finished. Up pops the setup wizard. Go ahead and click Next. On this screen, you can either choose custom to handpick the components you want, or you can go with the recommended default settings. Honestly, the default usually works great, and Android Studio will now start downloading all those necessary components. Inside the customize section, you get some cool options. For instance, I prefer the dark theme, it's much easier on the eyes, but if you like a different look, you can switch the visual theme right here. Okay, let's jump back to the projects tab. To start your first project, look for that little plus sign and click new project. By default, it'll start on the phone and tablet tab. But if you're building for a smartwatch, you can switch tabs here, a TV, a car, or even for extended reality. For our first app, let's stick with phone and tablet and select an activity template. I'm just going to select an empty activity for now. Give your project a name. You can leave things like the save location and the minimum SDK as they are. Just remember, the minimum SDK is the lowest Android version your app can run on. If a device has an older version, the app simply won't install. Now, this is where you need a little patience. When you hit Create, Android Studio uses a tool called Gradle. You can see the status bar at the bottom. Gradle is the brain that sets up your project, downloading libraries and checking configuration files. It absolutely needs an internet connection and you have to wait for this process to finish before you can really start coding effectively. You can click the status bar to see the detailed progress, and click it again to hide it. Time for the cool part, the AI. To get your coding assistant, click the Gemini icon on the left sidebar. It'll ask you to log in with your Google account. A browser window will pop up. Just sign in and confirm the account you want to use. Once you see the success message, flip back over to Android Studio. You'll have a few quick confirmations. Confirm you are over 18. Confirm the security settings and choose if you want all Gemini features or just the chat. Hit finish and you can start chatting with your AI. Quick tip, you can use it file name to attach a source file or at prompt to recall a saved prompt. Next to the chat tab is the agent tab. For more advanced actions, let's try a suggested prompt, like make my theme color scheme warmer. Gemini starts working, finding files like mapthemetk and then theme.tk. It reads the file, makes the change, and then asks if you accept the change, reject, or auto accept. I'll click accept. It does the same thing for the color.tk file, so I'll accept that too. Once it's done, the AI gives you a nice summary of everything it changed. Now, hit the play button to run your application. For now, it's just a simple Hello Android, but we're going to build this out into a full application in the next tutorials. You don't want to miss that. Be sure to subscribe to the Grapless channel right now to follow along with all the useful programming knowledge we have coming up. See you in the next lesson.